Hola y muy buenas noches. I'm Rafael Sanchez with RTV6, dressed up and ready for this special presentation. I'm so excited. Every year I look forward to driving to Richmond to celebrate the Amigos Richmond Latino Center. In that room, there's so much joy. There's so much possibility. There's so much giving. You can see the connection that people have with this great organization. So this special presentation is no different, because the organization in the midst of this pandemic is still doing such great work. It has helped people pay the utility bills. It is still holding online classes, and it's still involved in the community. So let's get started. Let this fiesta begin, and welcome, bienvenidos, as we celebrate Argentina.
Experience Argentina, presented by First Bank Richmond. You're going to have a night of fun, music, entertainment, dancing, cooking. Stay tuned. Don't miss it.
This group is just simply fun to watch. They are just amazing. Ladies and gentlemen, señoras y señores, I present Pavel and direct Contact!
Hey guys, I'm Pavel's cousin, and I'm a medical student here in Argentina, and I want to encourage you to support Amigos Latino Center.
I mean, we couldn't do what we do without First Bank and how supportive they have been throughout the years.
I've had a very good experience working with First Bank. They have been there really with all kinds of different things that I do in my life.
We consider First Bank Richmond a good friend. They're there to help us sponsor our signature events. You always are out there to help each other out.
Besides the business part of it, we just get along really well. It's beyond a working relationship.
We're having fun over here. You know, I just want to give a shout out to Monica and the Koshline Foundation, also to the Wake County Foundation for everything they do for us throughout the year, and also the Amigo staff. You know, we have Claudia, Jairo, Michelle, Carrie, Patty, Howard, and everybody else. Thank you so much, and the Amigos board. Stay tuned. Enjoy the night.
Every time we gather in Richmond, we have a great meal. Leah Crane, who sings with Pavel and Direct Contact, knows how to cook some really good food. I have my plate ready for her chimichurri and churrasco as she brings us some cuisine from Latin America. Leah, we are ready. Serve it up.
Apparently, skirt steak is very, it's a very rare cut of meat because there's only like four on the cow, or two or three, I don't know, it's not very many. So it's hard to find, and I went to a couple grocery stores to find it, but I finally found it. And you're going to cook it for like 2 minutes on each side. Oh, it looks awesome. Okay, so it's been going 2 minutes on each side, and now we are ready to stick it in here, and we're gonna let it rest.
Hi, how are you?
Good, I'm good.
That's good. So what are we doing here?
We are making a grilled skirt steak. And I did a little bit of reading about skirt steak, and there's not very many of them when you cut them off the cow. So it's kind of a hard to find meat.
Yeah, so by the way, skirt steak is in Argentina is called churrasco. Churrasco, yeah. Not easy to pronounce, but this looks really good. So what did you put in there?
I did what the recipe is called for, which was letting it sit with some white wine vinegar, onion powder, salt, pepper, and I let it sit in the fridge for a day. To marinate.
A day?
Yeah. Because skirt steak is very tough, and so you have to let it marinate for over a day so that it can break down the tissue.
Okay, sounds great. So what else do we have in here? I see some like cookies in here.
Yes, so this is a traditional dessert that's Argentinian dough. And it's called alfajores.
Yeah.
And it has a shortbread cookie on the bottom with dulce de leche.
Dulce de leche, yes.
De leche.
How do you say that in Spanish?
Sweet milk.
Yeah.
And so it's kind of like sweetened condensed milk that's been baked almost, and so it's a caramelized. Anyway, so you put that on the shortbread, and then you sprinkle some coconut. But my husband doesn't like coconut, so only half have coconut.
Wow. So what are we doing now?
Okay, now we are making the chimichurri sauce, which goes over the grilled skirt steak or churrasco. And chimichurri has onions, parsley, some recipes have cilantro, red wine vinegar, olive oil, garlic, and some spices. And then it said red chilies, so this is what I could find, but I'm pretty sure you can use crushed red pepper if you can't find these little, and I don't even know if these are ripe, but
Guys, try to find this in Richmond, Indiana.
I don't know. I think crushed red pepper is fine.
Okay,
you
think
so? I do, because I read other recipes.
Can you eat it?
I can.
Go ahead.
You want me to try it?
Yeah, eat it. There we go.
Oh, yeah, that's hot.
Yeah,
that's good. Really hot. Mm-hmm. Woo! I'm going to use a food processor to mix this up because it will be more uniform pieces, but you don't have to have a food processor. You could use a blender and just sort of pulse it a little bit, or you could chop everything up pretty small and then stir it in a bowl. So anyway, I've already chopped up the red onion here, and now I'm going to chop up the parsley. I snuck in some cilantro too, even though the recipe says it doesn't need it, but I think it needs it. So there's parsley and cilantro here. We washed it. And
wait, you put that much stuff in there?
Yeah.
That, wow. You're chewing, like, that's a lot of cilantro, guys, you know? This is good.
It is, yeah.
I love cilantro.
It'll be a lot, yeah. It'll be good.
Wow.
Okay. So you can just kind of roughly chop it because we're going to put it in the food processor.
Is this the food processor?
No, that's like a molcate, or I don't even know what this thing is, but that's the garlic that's in there. So
guys, look at this. Look at how this goes. This is amazing.
This part, shut up.
Yeah.
Let's put the salt in there and crush the garlic with the salt. I saw Gordon Ramsay do this, and it looked pretty cool when he was crushing the salt and the garlic. I don't know, it does something, makes some kind of reaction. It may not do that for me, I don't know.
But for some of you that don't know Leah, she's from Argentina. I'm kidding.
Yeah.
She's preparing the dinner for the Amigos Fiesta that is called Argentina. So, Sansi, what do you think?
I think it'll be very good.
Okay. Vámonos, amigos!
Special thanks to U.S. Bank Richmond for the long-standing relationship and the continued support. Thank you, U.S. Bank Richmond.
You know, this would have never been possible without the help. And I have to read it because there's so many. So we are so lucky to have these many sponsors. First Bank Richmond, West End Bank, U.S. Bank, Wetzel, IU East, ID Tech, G1013, Paul and Pat Lingle and Caldwell Banker Lingle, Earlham College, Manpower, El Bronco Restaurant, Best Western Classic Inn, Quick Family Foundation, and Most Money Factory. So thank you guys for everything you do for us.
Hello, it's me. I was wondering if after all these years community. It's where we live. It's where we work. It's where we play. At West End Bank, we're not just in the community, we're a part of the community. And that's why we support over 100 programs for local nonprofits and schools, including our financial literacy program that positively impacts countless students throughout the area. You bank locally, so we give back locally, to watch people grow with endless possibilities.
If you'd like to fund this organization, please visit AmigosLatinoCenter.org. I'll repeat that again, it's AmigosLatinoCenter.org. You can help us a lot, especially in this time where the staff is working so hard to make things happen.
Your path to a great career begins at Ivy Tech Community College. Whether you're looking to earn an associate degree, gain a new credential, or take a more affordable route to a bachelor's degree, Ivy Tech has what you need. Stop by a location or visit ivytech.edu.
Hello everyone, thank you for joining us tonight. I hope you're having fun. I am Claudia and I'm going to show you how to make some yerba mate. Yerba mate is a long tradition in Argentina. It is a loose leaf tea, very high in caffeine. You drink it out of a gourd. So you can buy the gourd online. It's called a mate. It comes with a bombilla, or a bombilla as they would say in Argentina. It is a silver like straw and is sealed at the very end and perforated at the bottom, so that when you drink your tea, you're not getting all of the leaves. You will get a little bit of them, but not bad. My mate is already cured. If you are just now buying one and you've never used it before, you're going to have to cure it, which helps your mate stay intact and last longer. In doing so, you will fill up your mate all the way with hot water, and you will leave it sit for 24 hours. If you're at home and you're curing it at home and you're doing it during the weekend, I would encourage you to take a peek at it every 2 to 3 hours and refill it with hot water. And what that's going to do is it's going to hydrate those microscopic pores inside of the gourd, and it will help your gourd stay fresh. I have already 4 tablespoons of loose tea in it. And I'm gonna put one more. Then you pour hot water in it. I would say about 3/4 of the way. In Cordoba, Argentina, some people put 1 teaspoon of sugar or so. In Buenos Aires, they drink it plain, just the tea, and they enjoy the bitterness more. Learn to enjoy it, get acquainted with it, develop a relationship with your tea, and just enjoy your tea. I love it. I hope you can give it a try. If you're interested in knowing where to buy one, I will share a link on our Facebook page. Thank you so much for joining us. Thank you to all of our sponsors and everyone in that community who have supported Amigos throughout this time. Please take care of yourselves and enjoy the rest of your evening.
Looking for a reliable, affordable new Honda? Look no further. All roads lead to Wetzel Honda. With market-based pricing on every new and used vehicle, you'll never overpay. With our Fresh Start program and 40 available lenders, we can find you the best financing available no matter what your credit score. And when you need service, we'll get you in the same day or next day, give you a loaner car if you need one, and your first oil change is always free. All roads lead to Wetzel Honda Richmond.
So I don't know if you can tell, but this is my living room. RTV6 put a TV studio in my home so that I could practice social distancing during the work week. So here we are. For this special presentation, we brought in musicians and performers really from around the world to entertain us this evening as we celebrate all the greatness of Argentina. Please join me as I welcome and say bienvenidos to Queen Tango from Washington, D.C.
Thank you. IU East has a beautiful campus. We're in Richmond. We're located on the northern side of town on about 180 beautiful acres. We have five buildings. The first one was Whitewater Hall. That was built in 1974. And most recently, we've added our fifth building, which is the Student Events and Activity Center. And that opened in 2016.
I think one of the things that often folks don't realize, we have 3,700 students here. Our campus is really split in a way. We have about half of those students are traditional age students who are coming right out of high school, and they're doing all those typical things that, you know, college age students do. And then we have this other aspect of our campus that's online, and that serves about a half of our students as well. And so we're able to serve both of these groups in a really great way.
We are an Indiana University campus right here in Richmond, so students can get an IU degree in their region.
An IU East degree holds just as much weight as a degree from IU Bloomington does, except you're getting a degree at a fraction of the cost as you would at a different campus. So I'm able to graduate debt-free in May, and that's something that a lot of students aren't able to say.
We have a small enough campus that students will really get to know their faculty, and their faculty will get to know them, yet it's large enough so that we have a full campus life, and students get the full college experience.
This campus can be everything that you want it to be. If you just want to come and go to class, you can do that. But if you want to be somebody who is out in front and leading and noticed, you're going to get that chance. And that doesn't happen everywhere.
You know, we have been having a fantastic night tonight. I hope you have too. We want you to support Amigos Latino Center so we can keep doing the job we are meant to. So if you do want to do that, please visit our website. It's at www.amigoslatinocenter.org.
Homeward bound, I wish I was. Homeward bound. Home, where my thoughts are skating. Home, where my music's playing. Home, where my love lies waiting
silently for me. Silently for me.
As many of you know, I'm a proud Dominican American. My parents emigrated from the Dominican Republic and the Caribbean years ago. One of our favorite dances on the island is merengue. It is energetic, it is fast moving. It is one of the many popular dances in all of Latin America. Of course, in Argentina, they love the tango. But they also enjoy cumbia, which also has its roots in Colombia. Let's join Kristen with the Ribbon Dance Company of Indianapolis, who shows us these great footsteps. Kristen? Take it away.
Argentina is known for tango, but of course has so many other music genres. It also has adapted a foreign dance, which is called cumbia. Taking this South American rhythm, Argentina has made it its very own, with various different styles. Cumbia is originally a dance from Colombia, but has gained immense popularity in Argentina, especially among the working class. And now live from Favela's house, we bring to you cumbia. And make sure to grab a glass of Argentinian wine and join us on the dance floor. Five, six, seven. sidestep. It looks like this. One, two, three, together, four. So it's two steps to the side, to your right side, and then two steps to your left side. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six. So a little bit faster with the music. Here we go. All right, basic. And now we're gonna do a turn here. This is kind of fun, so if you're interested in doing a turn, it's like shoulder turn. Step back with your basic. One, two, three, five, six, seven. Back basic. One, two, three, five, six, seven. One more time. Five, six, seven. We'll go back to the basic. One, two, three, five, six, seven. Okay. We can add another double sidestep. So remember the sidestep that was one, two, three, four, six, seven? We're gonna double that. So watch this. One, two, three, five, six, seven. One, two, three. Basic, here we go. One, two, three, five, six, seven. Let's add that turn. One, two, three, five.
Cause you're so good. Hi, I'm Rick Duncan from the G101.3 Morning Show, and I can't paint.
Hi, I'm Hoover from the G101.3 Afternoon Show, and I can't sports.
I'm Scott Epic from Epic Workdays, and I can't cook. But you know what we are great at, besides our music, of course? We're great at supporting community events.
That's right, Rick. Whether it's collecting coats, food, or just showing support, we're all in for our community.
And we're proud to call Richmond home. G101.3 is a proud supporter of IU East and the Whitewater Valley.
Hey, we cannot go also without thanking all of our sponsors, which I just said, but also my friends, right? People that made this happen, you know? My band, Pavel and Direct Contact, everybody in there. Also, Leah and Jeff Crane, great friend of ours. Also, Kristen Mutz. Also, Joan from Queen Tango and her group. You know, and also, the person that made the recipe, her recipe, my dear Yvonne Blanco. Thank you, baby. You know, I love you. Thank you. And guys, we can get through this, and the rest of the year is going to be great. So have a great night.
Earlham College is recognized by Princeton Review by offering one of the best classroom experiences anywhere.
So what is it that makes our classroom experience so great?
First, we have terrific professors who work at Earlham because they love to teach.
We have classes where everybody knows everybody and everybody has a voice.
We have students from all over the world.
Professors who have traveled, lived, and conducted research in multiple countries.
People who bring an incredible diversity of perspectives to classroom discussions.
Because it's not just what's on the syllabus. It's who's in the room.
I hope you've enjoyed this special presentation. It's different. I'm sure we all prefer to be back at the Country Club in Richmond, but here we are. I want to do a special toast to Pavel and to the Amigos Richmond Latino Center for continuing to do the great work that you do in supporting people throughout the community. This presentation, and with your support, will continue to connect with our neighbors and make their lives better. So for all of you involved, tonight, a toast, cheers to all of you. Thank you for watching. I'm Rafael Sanchez with RTV6. I look forward to seeing you next year in Richmond.